Okay, this guy we're calling Boyo. Lorraine here doesn't like the name, but people found him as a stray. That's what they had been calling him. You know, we've done every Thor, Zeus, Dakota, Juno, etc. So this is one I hadn't used, and I think it's kind of cute. She wrote and said, I'm reaching out because I took in a stray husky a little over a month ago. We've done everything we can to find his owners, but to no avail. We're struggling to care for him now as he does not get along with my cats. That's a husky thing for sure. I'm not sure how you guys do intake, but I figured I'd try, as everyone else I've contacted has been unable to help. I don't want to put him in a shelter where he might be at risk. We sent our intake questions, and he was estimated to be 10 to 12 months old. I think at least on the 12. He is a big boy. We kind of look at the size of his feet, too. We kind of wondered between his plumy tail and just his size at his age if he might not be Malamutan Husky. We call him Malberian. I think there's a good chance of that. Anyway, we don't know, and a lot of people do DNA on the dogs, and it's always sometimes a big surprise. She said he's a stray. He came up to our door. He does not get along with the cats. It's very hard to keep them separated. We have two cats and two dogs, not including him, and it's too much for us to care for. I want to say these people, these Good Samaritans that took this dog in, were great to work with. We had very limited space, so there was nothing we could do like immediately, and they kept him safe. They went in and got him the vaccinations he needed to legally come into the boarding kennel, and then they brought him here. So he really found his way to the right door, because you don't often see people that are willing to invest as much personally. You know, but people will help, but then they just want to get rid of the dog as soon as possible. So these folks were great. Anyway, she said he's a very sweet dog, loves attention, pets, and belly rubs. I think we may, I don't know if he's done belly rubs in this video, but we definitely have pictures of that. She said he can be a bit of a resource guarder, possessive of toys and food. So when he goes home, that's something you want to be aware of. They did have two other dogs in that home. So, you know, that can be handled, but you need to be attentive to it. Said with adults, he's great, just wants attention. They had not had him around children. I bet he'd be great. I mean, he is big and strong, but I would think he would be no threat to kids at all. Strangers said he does very well, runs up to them like they're a friend. I know, somebody's over there, right?
Yeah.
Who was that? I saw that head pop up. It's okay, I'm gonna keep talking. As far as the resource guarding, they said when he first got here, he would growl and sometimes try to snap at an animal or human who got near him when he had food or toys. We have been working on this with him, and he is getting a lot better. We taught him to drop it for when he has a toy, but is being too possessive over it. You know, sometimes we can try this stuff while we're doing videos, but usually they're just happy to be out of their kennel and a lot of distracting elements around. So, said he likes fetch. Okay, the husky that likes fetch is rare to me. Tug, run, and running in circles with my dogs, and of course loves going on walks. She had a female pit bull German Shepherd mix, a young male husky cattle dog mix, and started out I think a little rocky with them, but that they sorted everything out and they were getting along great after just initial introductions, which is always the case. I mean, you can't just throw them in and figure, you know, just stir and it's done. Again, the cats were an issue. She said he chases them, and we can only assume this is not for a good reason, kind of like we talked about on the way over here. We always ask if they chase small animals like squirrels, etc. She said yes, chases our cats. Our neighbors have two small dogs on the other side of the fence, and he'll run up and down the fence with them all day, but doesn't seem to be aggressive. When we ask about aggression, the only thing she mentioned, again, was the resource guarding. Here, this is always good news for people. He's been living indoors a couple hours a day outside to potty, take walks, etc. And they did keep him in a separate room from the cats when they were away. But she said he is housebroken. He does not chew. He doesn't tear anything up when alone. We always ask about crate training. They said they haven't used a crate. He did fine just being in a room by himself. Let's see. Again, no destruction. They had a 4-foot chain link fence that he never challenged. That's another great thing for this breed, especially such a big dog. No effort to dig, climb, jump. He stayed in the yard. She said he knows sit, shake, and speak. I don't know if we want to... He knows give me a belly rub.
He likes getting a belly rub.
He does. Okay, so they say he knows that. We're not going to push it. We're trying to get out of the way here. She said, the leash, she said, does well, only tugs when he really wants to go smell something. Well, anytime we get him out of the kennel, they pull a little bit, but he's not uncontrollable by any means. Set in the car, he lays down, looks out the window. I mean, he's pretty much a laid-back guy. The typical phobias, like not scared of fireworks, strangers, thunderstorms, vacuum cleaner, you know, some of those things that freak some dogs out have not been an issue with him. And she said again, we're struggling to continue caring for him as myself. We're returning back to work full time. He needs to stay separated from our cats. The volunteer said, very handsome boy, did well when Alex ran with him. We have a volunteer, Alex, who's very athletic and a runner. They all love spending time with Alex because they get to go for a run. And Elaine said he was great with everybody in the play yard. I don't know if that meant they turned him loose in the play yard. Have you had him loose with other dogs? Has he been? Okay. So we haven't had him out with anybody. We're real careful about that. But like they said, he was with two much smaller dogs in the last setting. And while it started out a little, you know, tricky, it turned out just fine. And everybody settled in and they played together. So this video's gone on too long. I'm just going to roll in and look at him. Hi, buddy. And this is Boyo, certainly to be renamed.